When two people pledge to love and care for each other in marriage, they create a spirit unique to themselves, which binds them closer than any spoken or written words. Marriage is a promise made between two people who love one another, who have decided that life together brings more joy and promise than life apart, and that the days of the future are made indefinitely brighter with one's beloved than apart. It is with this understanding, then, that Matthew and Kirby have come to form a union in the presence of family and friends who rejoice with them in the making of this important commitment. Matthew and Kirby, the covenant you make is a beautiful and sacred expression of your love for each other. As you offer your vows to each other, and as you commit your lives to each other, we all wish for you a deep sense of joy with the conviction that you are committing yourselves to a dynamic, growing relationship of trust, mutual support, and a deep and abiding love. Now I'd ask the parents to come up for a minute, join us. There is an Irish wedding tradition called the ring warming. In that tradition, the rings to be worn by the bride and groom are passed sometimes among all guests, sometimes the wedding party. The purpose of the tradition is to ask those warming the rings to think of the couple and say a prayer for the couple. Today we ask the parents of Matthew and Kirby warm the rings of their children and to pass on through your prayers and deep and abiding love for them as they prepare to enter into the covenant of marriage. Now you get the back, Jane. Thank you. Matthew and Kirby have chosen the following reading entitled Blessing of a Marriage by James Dillard Freeman. The reading will be offered by Kirby's godmother, Kathy Ross.
Where should I go? Stand by you.
Ready? May your marriage bring you all the exquisite excitements a marriage should bring, and may life grant you also patience, tolerance, and understanding. May you always need one another, not so much to fill your emptiness as to help you to know your fullness. A mountain needs a valley to be complete. The valley does not make the mountain less, but more. And the valley is more a valley because it has a mountain towering over it. So let it be with you and with you. May you need one another, but not out of weakness. May you want one another, but not out of lack. May you entice one another, but not compel one another. May you embrace one another, but not out encircle one another. May you succeed in all important ways with one another and not fail in the little graces. May you look for things to praise and often say, I love you, and take no notice of small faults. If you have quarrels that push you apart, may both of you hope to have a good sense enough to take a step back. May you enter into the mystery, which is the awareness of one another's presence, no more physical than spiritual, warm and near when you are side by side, warm and near when you are in separate rooms or even distant cities. May you have happiness and may you find it making one another happy. May you have love and may you find it in loving each other. Amen.
To the Keenan family, the Sullivan family, to all the extended family, and the friends of Matthew and Kirby, your love and support have played an essential role in who Matthew and Kirby are today. Your love and support play a strong role in their future. With this in mind, I ask you to proclaim your vows to Matthew and Kirby as they enter into marriage. Your response will be, I do. Do you promise to take Matthew and Kirby into your families, into your hearts, promising to encourage and inspire them? Do you promise to accept them, not only as individuals, but as a couple? Do you promise to be their friends and a source of their joy today and every day that follows? Your vows are as solemn as theirs.
Kirby. I can't believe we're finally here. We've been together for 3,000. Yeah. I'm crying. Yeah. You want me to hold it?
No, I'll hold it.
We've been together for 3,009 days, as of today. In that time, I've watched you amaze me and inspire me with your commitment to becoming a doctor. From grinding through undergrad as a biochem major, watching you study full days for your MCAT, going through med school applications, interviews, getting through med school, your step exams, the residency application process, those interviews, match ceremonies, going through residency, and soon, potentially, fellowship. That's a lot. And you did all of that while being the absolute best dog mom our little girl Lindy could possibly ask for. Although, I'm sure she would say she could have used some more sweet potatoes. In those 3,009 days, we have lived in the same city, different apartments, different cities, same city, same apartment, different countries. All of this changed, but the one constant for me was knowing that I wanted to be here with you today. Before we started dating, we became best friends. We've only built on that in these past 8 years. You're the first person I want to grab a drink with. The first person I want to see a movie with, the first person I want to talk to every day. Basically, just doing life with you is fun. I'm trying. I truly feel that I am the luckiest person in the world today, and every other day I get to spend with you, whether that's in person or remotely while you're doing a 28-hour shift at the hospital. In the next 3,009 days, and every day after that, I promise to continue to find vegetarian meals to make you after long days. I promise to continue to be the absolute weirdest human on earth with you. I'll continue to make a new nickname for Lindy at least once a month. I'll be your ear to vent to when life gets too stressful. I'll be your shoulder to cry on when you're too tired. Being able to love and support you has and will continue to be the biggest honor of my life. I cannot wait to see all the memories we continue to make for the rest of our lives together. I love you forever and always.
Okay. Sorry for Lindy crying. Okay.
Help me get through it. Right.
Okay. Matt, I am so grateful for the life we've built together over the last 8 years. We've both grown so much, and I've loved every version of you along the way. From the goofy best friend distracting me in the study room when I was trying to study, to the also goofy, completely loving dog dad you've become, and everything in between. I honestly can't imagine my life without you in it. I am so lucky that the love of my life also happens to be a phenomenal cook, the most thoughtful person I know, and an incredible dog dad to Lindy. I remember telling my grandma, Dee, that not only do you search every restaurant we go to beforehand to make sure that there's something that I can eat there, but that you also found ways to make vegetarian versions of every one of your favorite foods and mine so that I could never miss out on anything. She said, you better hold on to that one, and she couldn't have been any more right. You've stuck by me through so much, like you mentioned, from crazy study days in college when I'd fall asleep 5 minutes into every time we'd hang out, every long distance in med school, with Friday night drives down to see me almost every weekend, to now long night shifts when you make sure I have lunch packed and that I eat enough when I get home. Not a day goes by where I don't feel loved and supported by you, and I promise to try every day to make you feel even a fraction of the same. We have made many little traditions, like dancing to the songs that come on commercials, while changing all the lyrics to be about Lindy, and homemade pizzas every Valentine's Day, and I can't wait to make a million more of those with you. I promise to always be there for you as a shoulder to cry on, a goofy distraction, or a second set of eyes on a problem. I promise to make time for bagel sandwich dates, even when life gets really busy. And I promise to try every day to make you feel as loved as you've made me feel every day since I've known you. I promise to never stop doing little things to make your day better or appreciating the little things you do for me. And I promise to love you through every bump that may come our way and to find something to laugh about along the way. I will never stop looking at the life we've built together with absolute awe that I'm lucky enough that I get to live it with you. And I will never forget all the sacrifices you've made to get us to this point where we get to live it. I'm so thankful that I get to call such a loving, dependable, thoughtful goofball my husband, and I love you forever and always.
Very nice. Matthew and Kirby, your friends and family have proclaimed their love for you. You are a lucky couple. A wedding is more than a celebration of the life which lives in your heart today. It reaches into the future and proclaims your intentions for the rest of your lives. You are joined not only by the mutual affection and the love you share, but also by your hopes, dreams, and the promise of what will be. The promises and vows you make this day shall guide you into the common future. This commitment is made in love, kept in faith, lived in hope, and eternally made new. Now for the ring exchange. The ring is a symbol of the unbroken circle of love, a symbol that the love between you will never cease. Love freely given has no beginning and no end, no giver and no receiver. May these rings always remind you of the vows you have taken this day. Shane, please give Kirby's ring to Matthew. Matthew, please repeat after me. Kirby, I give you this ring.
Kirby, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my love and fidelity.
As a symbol of my love and fidelity.
The constant presence of my love for you.
The constant presence of my love for you.
I ask you to wear this ring.
I ask you to wear this ring.
As a reminder of the vows we have spoken today.
As a reminder of the vows we have spoken today.
Okay, Shane. Thank you. Kirby, please repeat after me. Matthew, I give you this ring.
Matthew, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my love and fidelity.
As a symbol of my love and fidelity.
The constant presence of my love for you.
The constant presence of my love for you.
I ask you to wear this ring.
I ask you to wear this ring.
As a reminder of the vows we have spoken today.
As a reminder of the vows we have spoken today.
An Irish blessing. May your mornings bring joy and your evenings bring peace. May your troubles grow few as your blessings increase. May your hands be forever clasped in friendship and your hearts forever joined in love. Your lives are very special and God has touched you in many ways. May his blessings rest upon you and fill all your coming days. I ask you all to respond with a rousing amen to the following prayer. Loving Creator, renew with us an affectionate and loving spirit.
Amen.
Enrich our lives with the gracious gift of love so that we may embrace others with that same love.
Amen.
Bless Matthew and Kirby with all good things.
Amen.
Matthew and Kirby, we have gathered, we have prayed. You told each other that you love one another. The only thing left to be said is by the authority vested in me by the American Marriage Ministries, I pronounce you husband and wife. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the most newly married couple on the planet, Matthew Keenan and Kirby Sullivan. The groom may now kiss his beautiful bride. You can shut me off now.
Thank you. platform in vain. The Puerto Ricans, they were playing this sauce in the rain. With open doors and manual locks and fast food parking lots, I headed west, I was a man on the moon. New York had lied to me, I needed the truth. Oh, I need somebody, I needed someone I could trust. And I don't gamble, but if I did, I would bet on it. Like the Dead Sea, you told me I was like the Dead Sea. You'll never see.
First of all, I get a little nervous talking in front of people, so forgive my stammering, but I'm going to read this thing instead of trying to memorize here. But first, I would just want to say hello and welcome. I'm Brian, Kirby's dad, of course, along with my wife, Kathy, and Matt's parents, Tim and Kathleen. I want to thank you all for attending. Some of you traveling from far away, and the bridesmaids and groomsmen, we know this is a big commitment. We really appreciate it. I also want to thank the Keenans for the rehearsal dinner last night. That was awesome. We had a great time. The food was great, and it was great getting to know you guys this week. I also want to thank my wife, Kathy, and she's going to kill me for this because I told her I wouldn't do this, but I want to thank her because she worked really hard on this event, and she had all of her spreadsheets and all this stuff. She worked very hard, and she did a lot of praying to her mom to make sure that this was a beautiful day. And I think it turned out to be a perfect day. So I also want to say, I can't believe this day is here. How time has flown. Doesn't seem that long ago that Kirby was a baby. You know, we're given these little miracles, and we want to hold them tight and protect them from the world. But of course you can't. You have to let them go. But each time they go out and accomplish the next step in life, a bit of your heart goes with them. You're so proud and happy for them. But your heart breaks a little too, because you know it's one step closer to them leaving the nest. The weight of that came upon me one night while I was rocking Kirby to sleep when she was a baby. And I was thinking, one day this little angel's gonna get married and leave us. And a song started coming to me, of course, the first line of which is, I saw this coming years ago while rocking you to sleep. And when I set her down in the crib, I went and wrote the rest of that song about her wedding day. And when I dance with her one last time, and she'd go off to her new life. And now it's here. I can't believe it's here already. But poor Kirby, this song's been hanging over her for 20-something years. And she had no choice but to pick it as our song to dance to tonight. So sorry, Kirby. But you can just picture it, though, right? Kirby goes off to kindergarten, and I'm at home crying, singing, I saw this coming years ago. And then she started having sleepovers with friends, and I'm like, wait, this is starting already? What the heck? I saw this coming. Anyway, it's Kirby's fault. We loved having her with us all the time. She's such a blessing. She was a good baby and a great kid growing up. She made being a parent easy. She not only has her mom's beauty, but she's sweet like her too. I love watching them together, their little giggle fits, which really reminds me of Kathy and her mom, Dee, who used to have the same little giggle fits where they couldn't stop giggling, and her sisters too. And Kathy and Kirby say the same things all the time, and you know, they're like, it's a little mini me sometimes. She got a lot of Kathy's great features. I'd like to think she got some from me too, but I'd like to think she got her brains from me, but she's way smarter than me. Or maybe her singing ability, but her voice is way better than mine. She did get my blonde hair, but neither of us are blonde anymore. I guess she got my temper, or so we're both told. But what I did try to give to her was time, attention, and love, and I've gotten that back in spades. Being Kirby, Ian, and Connor's dad is the best thing I've done with my life. You know, Kirby always had a good moral compass, choosing not to be one of the mean girls, sticking up for underdogs, helping every wounded creature, animal or human. We still have the dog pinata that she refused to hit on her birthday. True story. We found it while we were moving, and it was in the attic. I was like, really? We still have this thing? We can't kill this thing off yet? Anyway, we thought that Kirby would end up being a veterinarian, but once she found out you had to put dogs down, she decided that was not what she was going to do. So about at age 11 or so, she wanted to be a doctor, and she made that dream come true. But Kirby wasn't some super serious person. She was very goofy and fun, especially at home. Out in public, she was shy and reserved. But a few experiences have really boosted her confidence. One was when she went off to Camp Ernst. I was dead set against her leaving us for so long in the summers, but glad we let her. Her friends there at camp said, Kirby is so outgoing. And we were like, really, Kirby? And I joked that place is a cult, but it sure boosted her confidence and helped her become a servant leader. And some of her friends from camp are here tonight, somewhere in here. There's the camp people. And then at Seton High School. She played 4 years of lacrosse, but I think her time in the drama program was more impactful. She not only had to get up on stage and sing and act in front of audiences, but she met a great group of lifelong friends there. And those friends are here tonight. Shout out. So we were sad when Kirby went off to college. I could definitely feel my heart breaking then. But we were so proud she got accepted into Ohio State's biochemistry for pre-med. She was salutatorian at Seton, but this was a whole new level, and she rose to the challenge of tough academics and big campus life. I'm really proud of you for that, Kirby. It was another thing that really made you grow, I think. She also met a good group of friends from OSU who are here tonight as well. She also met some guy up there. I think his name is Matt or something like that. I'm not sure. And she and Kathy talked on the phone every day on Kirby's way to and from classes, as they still do on her way to and from work now. So Kathy knew before Kirby that she and Matt were going to be a couple. I remember Kathy getting off the phone saying, "I can tell she really likes this guy, and I think he likes her too." And I gotta say, I really didn't want that to be the case. No offense, Matt, but I was like, wait, who is this guy? She needs to be focused on school, not boys. And then I'm sure I saw this coming. But truth is, I really didn't want our family to change. Kathy and I were blessed with the family we always wanted. Ian, Kirby, and Connor were so close. They liked being together and with us. They were very well behaved, but the few times when they were put in the corner when they were little, the other two would go into the corner with them and play. And we're like, this is really solving things. But they didn't want the other one to be lonely. They always were very close. So we had so many great times together, and Kirby made them all even better. I love how excited she gets for Christmas, sled riding where she'd sit at the bottom of the hill eating snow. And then she'd want to go in and have hot chocolate and cookies by the fire and watch Disney movies and Harry Potter. And we can't see cotton candy at a Reds game without thinking of Kirby with that red sugar all over her face and her cute little blonde curls. And she was my ice cream buddy. We still call a big scoop of ice cream a Kirby scoop. I was never ready for any of that to end. So we were very happy when Kirby matched at UC Med School. At least she'd be in town when she wasn't visiting Matt in Columbus. And at med school, she met some of the best friends any parent could want for their child. And as you can see, a lot of them are here tonight. So when Kirby matched at George Washington in D.C. for her residency, our hearts really broke again because she was leaving us. But we're happy she and Matt have met some new friends up there, and Matt's family and old friends are there too. And I'm so glad so many of you can make it here tonight. As much as I wasn't ready for Kirby to find a guy and leave us, we couldn't ask for a better person for her to share her life with. Tim and Kathleen, you've done a great job raising Matt. He is so responsible and caring, a good human being. He takes great care of Kirby, tolerating her long hours, switching from days to nights. Sorry, I swore I wasn't gonna cry. And as you heard, Vals, if you could hear him, Matt is a really good cook, and he has even learned how to create vegetarian skyline chili for Kirby. And Matt fits in so well with our family as well. It was clear he'd probably fit in when his first time with our family was at a Bruce Springsteen concert. And he got to witness Psycho Springsteen Kathy in action. And he didn't take that as the clear sign it was to run away. And his love, or should I say, obsession with sports makes Ian, Connor, and Matt even closer. Kirby couldn't help but become a sports person with those three guys in her life. Now all of us, including Ian's wife, Maddie, love getting together, playing cards, watching movies, going to trivia nights, or hitting a brewery. And he's really added to our family. And with how he treats their little dog, Lindy, like a little princess, I'm sure he'll be a great dad. But we will have to work on making sure their kids are Bengals fans. Yep, Houdet. And see the Ravens for what they really are. Ex-Browns. So, seriously though, it's so great to see how happy Kirby and Matt are together. All those little heartbreaks we felt were actually growing pains from our hearts expanding. Getting ready to hold all the new love we'd have watching our family grow and our children being happy. And today my heart is full. So I've gone on way too long, but I want to thank everyone who helped shape these two wonderful people. It truly takes a village. And Kirby and Matt, look around you. This room is filled with people who are here for you when you need them. You are truly blessed. And Kirby, I love you, and I'm so proud of you. I might not be able to rock you to sleep anymore. Damn it. Or protect you from the world, but I will always be here for you, and you'll always be my little girl. So, let's raise your glasses for Kirby and Matt. Get my glass with you. That's fine. Any glass. So, to Kirby and Matt, may you have a long marriage and wonderful life together, and we can't wait to share it with you. Congratulations. We love you both. Cheers. I got a mic in my hand.
Love you.
Love you. Wow.
That was so
good.
Thank God that's over.
I'm so glad it's over. So now we'll have some good speakers who don't cry.
Well, I definitely don't want to follow that because that was amazing, but I'm going to do my best. So, hi everyone, my name is Christine. I am one of two of Kirby's maids of honor, along with Elise, who will be giving a short speech later too. I first met Kirby freshman year of high school in Dr. Mullen's biology class, and one day I chose Kirby as my lab partner, which was not only a great decision for my grades, because we all know how brilliant Kirby is, but she also went on to become one of my best friends in the entire world. Kirby and I experienced so much in high school. We made friends, we lost friends. She excelled at AP calculus while I desperately tried to keep up with her. And finally, we found our own little family in the Selder Theater Department. We then went on to become roommates at Ohio State, and we had a lot of fun there. We went to football games. Sometimes we didn't make it to football games. And we also, on one very hungover Sunday morning, adopted a little chihuahua named Lindy. I honestly, if you would have told me she'd be walking down the aisle at Kirby's wedding 10 years later, unbelievable, honestly. Ohio State is also where we both met the lovely Matt Keenan, or as I call him, Cat Meenan. Yes, I have drawn cat whiskers and a nose on him before. Kirby and I were super lucky. We found a great group of friends, our freshman year dorm, Patty Four. We got a lot of you guys here today. Little did we know that one of those dorm mates was Kirby's future husband. And, you know, Kirby and Matt became quick friends. We all loved Matt. He is, as we still say today, a walking green flag. He would always walk us home, make sure nobody, you know, was going to walk home alone, made sure we all got home safe. But Kirby and Matt, yes, they were good friends, but we could all tell there was something a little more. They were definitely both in denial. I remember one night we went to the lighting of Mirror Lake, me, Kirby, and Matt, and I compared us to the Harry Potter trio, but quickly added, you two cannot start dating. It would ruin it. And we all laughed like that was an absurd idea. Like, no way, no way. And now I'm speaking at their wedding. So that did not work out. But once Kirby and Matt got together, I mean, it was very clear she found her person. She was so at ease with him. They had so much fun together. And I think, like Brian said, everyone just kind of knew they were going to be together forever. I feel incredibly lucky to have seen their relationship from the very beginning. And you really could not find a more perfect match than Kirby and Matt. Not only did Kirby find an incredible husband, but Lindy found a father. And he is the best father for Lindy I could ever imagine. So Matt, thank you for taking care of our chaotic but brilliant Kirby. Kirby, I love you so much. I am so happy for you, and I love you both. Congratulations.
First off, I want to thank both sides of our family, the Keenans, obviously, and the Sullivans. Thank you so much for letting this happen. It's been an honor and a privilege to meet all of you. Honored to be a part of this small army you call a wedding party. I do not think we could have done it at ours. I would have been done. But for those of you that don't know me, my name's Shane. I have the honor and privilege of being Matt's best man for this wedding. But the title I hold closer is more best brother. I'll take that till I die. Honestly, I don't think I'll get a better title in life. Best part about being an older brother, though, is you get to see everything the younger brother does and hold most of the memories. I'll go over vacations, and they're like, I have no idea what you're talking about. Best part, he still doesn't know what he's done. We were up in Maine one time. First time he has Coca-Cola. Goes around the room, he's like, Coke. And he just keeps repeating the phrase, Coke. And it's like, all right, like, we get it. It's a soda. Like, I was able to see him grow into the man he is today. It really should be the best brother, like I said. But Kirby, you've done a great job with him. Cat whiskers and all. Loved it. Some best man speeches throw in roasts and jokes, but I'd rather tell a story instead. Stories about a boy in sports. We all know Matt loves his sports. He would literally go, can we go to practice? And it's like an hour before his practice. And it's like, all right, like, practice doesn't start till 6. And he's like, 4 o'clock, can we go? Can we go? It's like, okay, sure, like, let's go. We'd go to the field, and we'd literally just pass the ball for like an hour, hour and a half, 2 hours, and then finally the kids start showing up on his team. And it's like, all right, man, like, now it's like 2 hours later. Finally coming home, we get Taco Bell, because we're both hungry. Baja Blast, of course, Kirby. You know. I think we played sports our entire life, our whole life, up until college, for Matt stopped because he couldn't do it, and then I tore my ACL in college, so I stopped. But neither of us won a championship ring. And today, Matt, you definitely got your championship ring with Kirby. Kirby, you are an amazing human being. You're sweet, smart, and kind. I think I knew you were perfect for Matt, besides obviously common law marriage, damn near close. I think you, like, maybe a year off. But we were all at this brewery a couple years back, and this guy passes out outside this brewery, and it's my sister, my now wife, and Matt and Kirby, and Kirby rushes over to this person. She's like, oh my God, are you okay? Guy's out cold, finally comes to, and Kirby's like, going all doctor. And there's Matt right next to her, just being just as kind, empathetic with the person. I think that's really what makes these two work so well, that they're so simpatico with each other, being so kind, innate human beings. If everyone will raise their glasses with me, cheers to Matt and Kirby. Today's day to celebrate their beautiful wedding. Cheers to love, life, laughter, and a happily ever after. To Matt and Kirby, we love you both. And obviously, Lindy is now no longer a bastard, so.
Hi, everyone. Last speech, so your salads are waiting for you. My name is Elise Rupert, but you probably know me better as Kirby's camp friend, referenced earlier. I just wanted to say today I was lucky enough to be one of the many onlookers of the first look between Matt and Kirby, my personal doctor and my personal doctor's caretaker. It was really special. It was true love realized. It was just very moving. I just love you guys so much. Anyway, okay, back to my actual prepared speech. Okay, so again, you probably know me better as Kirby's camp friend. And one of the beautiful things about summer camp is the bubble that it creates for its campers and its counselors. And that bubble means that while I have not met a lot of people in this room before, at least prior to the bachelorette party, I've heard a lot about you, each and every one of you, lots of stories. My camp friendships, especially what I have with Kirby and the bubble that it's grown in and has existed in, reminds me of a quote. And that quote is, "Everybody that I've ever known knows your name. You are all in my favorite stories. They know my love for you before they even meet you." So Kirby's been a main character in my story since 2012, which is crazy. And all of you here today have been main characters in her stories. So to that I say, it's nice to put a face to the name. Our friendship formed over bunk beds and s'mores and creek hikes, better known as crikes. And while at camp, we made many, many stories for ourselves, including, there's one that comes to mind. There was a day where it was the camp dance, and Kirby and I decided to dress up in trash bag dresses, you know, fun, goofy, until you're on a blacktop in July wearing a trash bag. You've never seen two more dehydrated women. You would think a future doctor would know better. But yeah, fast forward to our college years, and some new characters were introduced into Kirby's story, including the crew from her freshman hall. I learned a lot about these characters over multiple phone calls that first year. A lot of conversations were focused on the nicest guy, but they were just friends. As an outside reader, the introduction of a love interest was clear. I got to know Matt over a series of visits to OSU. Those trips were often blurs, often happening during spring game, the spring block. And those blurry trips had even blurrier excursions to Waffle House. Those stories have been redacted. I can't share them with you today. But one thing is clear, this main character was here to stay. And together you've written so many new chapters in Columbus and Cincinnati and now DC. And it's been amazing to cheer you both on along the way. Matt really is the nicest guy I was told about, except I'm starting to think he's more than just a friend. He is so kind, so caring, so patient, and such an amazing partner to Kirby. And Matt, I'm so happy that you've become a main character in Kirby's life and that she's got you in her corner. Matt and Kirby, you've written a beautiful love story, and I'm so excited for this next chapter and the many more to come. So to that, let's raise a glass to Matt and Kirby. I love you both.
Sit beside me, my only son. Listen closely to what I say. And if you do this, it'll help you some sunny day. Thank you.
I saw this coming years ago while rocking you to sleep. Your little arms around my neck, soft breath on my cheek. Forgive me for holding on too tight, can't seem to let go. The last dance, you're my little girl. I tried to savor every smile, a little subtlety. Years fly by, you blink your eyes, soon they're memory. So I tried to hold on tight to stop this spinning world. 'Cause this will be the last dance that you're my little girl. This will be the last dance, then I'll step aside. You'll dance on to your new life. I'm proud of you, my child. You can always come back home from anywhere in this world. But this will be the last dance that you're my little girl. Try to hold on tight to stop this spinning world. 'Cause this will be the last dance that you're my little girl. Deep in my heart, you'll always be Daddy's little girl.
Loving you the way I do, I know we're gonna make it through. And I would go to the end of the earth, 'cause darling, to me that's what the world.